Hi everyone, I'm Stefan Chandler Garcia, a developer evangelist here at Salesforce. Now, one of the most common questions I see asked around the internet when it comes to developing Lightning Web Components is the ability to capture information around a button that was clicked or an element that was just selected in our HTML and maybe capture that information in our JavaScript. Now, today I'm going to be talking about data attributes and how they can help you solve that problem. So, first let's go ahead and take a look at the scenario that we're trying to solve for today. Here we have a list of contacts that have been organized into tiles, and each tile is part of a list item. And when I select on the tile, there's an onClick that's triggered, and that event is captured in our JavaScript file, but we're not doing anything with it yet. I'd like to be able to take that selected contact and add it to that selected contacts list on the right-hand side of the screen. Now, it's important to note that when you capture an event from that onClick, you're pretty much capturing that entire HTML element, that maybe in this case list item or that div ID, its classes, maybe its value, and taking that information, and then you're getting that in your event, and you can take that and manipulate it as you wish in your JavaScript. Now, let's go ahead and add just that standard ID. So let's go ahead and add a div ID to this, or in this case, a list item ID, and just call it ID, and then say it equals contact.id, and capture the contact ID in that iteration there, and pass that into our HTML. So let's go ahead and go back into our LWC and refresh the page there. And as that loads, let's go ahead and inspect the list item and check out our results. So here we can see it has passed in that ID, and we have our div ID there, but it's not the ID that you'd be expecting. It's a Salesforce ID that has a number appended onto the end of it. In this case, it's -29. And that is done through the Lightning runtime. It relies on those ID attributes of your HTML elements to orchestrate that Lightning experience, really, thus makes them unusable for us. And so in this case, we can't actually rely on those IDs because we don't know what number or what characters are going to be appended onto the end of them. So that's where data attributes are going to come in and save the day. And those data attributes allow you to apply custom attributes that you specify to that element. And they just start out with data and then dash whatever you like. It could be data-ID, data-email, data-name, really anything that you can think of or add onto that element, you can using those data attributes. In this case, let's add data-ID equals contact.id. And just for fun, let's go ahead and add data-email equals contact.email. Now, what about data-contact and maybe pass in that entire contact object? Well, it doesn't work that way because data attributes must be strings. And so you can pass in the contact, but it won't render as that contact details in that element. You could maybe stringify the contact and pass that as a string into the element because there isn't really a limit on characters in your data attributes. But to be honest, you don't really want to be exposing that much information into your attributes because they are available by anyone inspecting your markup or your HTML in there. And so let's go ahead and inspect that. And there you go. We can see it's added our data attributes, our ID, and our email there into the element. That way, when that onClick is fired, we get that element and we can capture that ID and email in our JavaScript file for use. In this case, we want to add that contact to the list. And so let's go ahead and go into our JavaScript. And the first thing we want to do is modify our handleClick method that we're calling in our onClick. Let's go ahead and set up a constant for that selected contact ID. We'll just call it contact ID. We can say equals and then event.currentTarget so that we're targeting that specific element that was clicked. And then .dataset to instantiate those data attributes, .id. And that will give us that ID right from the element into our constant. And so now let's go ahead and let's push that contact ID into our add contact to selected record list method. And let's go ahead and put our contact ID there. And we're just going to pass the ID into method to abstract that functionality from this actual on-click handler here. And so in there, though, let's go ahead and set up a constant for our selected contact, because we want to search through those contact records and find the right contact based on their ID. And to do that, we're going to use a really cool JavaScript feature called filter. And so we're going to say this.contactRecords.filter. And filter is going to let us specify a property for a single contact through the iteration. And then we can then match that contact.id to our contact ID that we're passing in. And it will return that list of contacts that were matched using the filter. So then we can go ahead and take our property for selected contact records. And we're going to take that and we're going to concatenate it to those results. And so we just want to put in selected contact here. And so it's important to note that when you have results coming from a filter, they're always expressed in an array because there could be multiple matches on that filter. So let's go ahead and push that to our org and refresh the page and check out the results. And there you go. We're clicking on the element and taking that ID and passing it to our JavaScript file, and then using the filter to find the matching contact and adding it to the list. And that's what then allows it to update on the UI. And so hopefully you've learned a little bit about data attributes today and how you can use them to capture information around those elements that are clicked. In a future quick take, we're going to be going through some advanced usage of data attributes, but hopefully this will help inspire you and help you solve some of the problems you may have been facing. Thank you very much, everyone, for checking out this video. Please subscribe to the Salesforce Developers YouTube channel for more quick takes, and please like and share this on your social channels. If you'd like to interact with myself, you can follow me on Twitter at StephanWCG or find me on email at Stephan.Garcia@Salesforce.com. Thank you very much for checking out the quick take. I'm looking forward to sharing more exciting content with you. Thanks, everyone.